Welcome back, you're watching Market Pulse. Now Magma FinCorp has posted a stable set of numbers, but there's a slight uptick in the NPAs, obviously on a year-on-year basis. Let's discuss and decode the numbers and the quarter gone by with Atul Bansal, he's CFO at the company. Good afternoon, Mr. Bansal, it's good to have you on the show. Let's start off with your headline numbers in and as of itself. The profit is absolutely stable, 47 versus 46 crores, while the total income has dipped really marginally. Take us through the key highlights and then we'll come to the NPAs later.
Sure. So if you look at it, our NIM expansion is about 40 basis. PBT is up 14% and the PAT was up 2%. If you look at even in terms of disbursements, if you look at our three businesses, the asset-backed business is about 12 to 14% year-on-year. The SME business is up 25%. And in the mortgage business, as we look to move to tier towns and get down to lower ticket, we've seen a reduction in that.
Sir, about the NPAs, I mean, it's 8.6.
Yeah, so the NPAs have moved up, but if you look at it from November onwards, we've seen a general stabilization in our NPA portfolio. Obviously, the first quarter is a weak quarter. That, together with the small decline in the book, has resulted in the NPA ratio moving up. However, if you look at the months of May, June, and July, we've actually seen rollbacks in the book in the last 3 months.
How is the monsoon panning out in terms of the lending trends, and are you seeing that pick up, or you think the lag effect will happen only from next quarter onwards? If you can throw some light there.
One is on the infrastructure side, they're seeing a lot more spending, and therefore that also then has a lag effect on rural. The monsoon is having its effect, and we believe that the monsoon, together with the spending by the government, the seventh pay commission, of which we believe about 50% will go into rural India, so see the benefits both on the disbursement side and on the collection side in the second half of the year.
Right. Sure.
Mr. Bansal, in terms of the NPAs, I mean, coming back to that again, the gross number stands at 8.71% and the net number stands at 6.92%. Are you completely done with the 120-day recognition period? And going ahead, do you see a further spike? What is the watch list that you have right now in terms of the probable accounts that may slip into NPAs possibly in the next quarter? Can you share some numbers there with us as well, as also the provisions and write-offs?
Sure. So what happens is we have been on 120 days for the last couple of years. So we actually did not need to make the transition to 120. We already were on 120. You have to also realize that we are a retail book, and therefore there is no watch list of large accounts. And I'm assuming that this is in reference to what the, you know, most people ask the banks. So our average ticket sizes are 4 to 5 lakhs on tractors, on CV and CE less than 20, and even on the SME and mortgage, we run 15 to 16 lakhs. So we are a retail play, and therefore, we don't see the same impact as the watch list on a large organization.
Mr. Bansal, the growth in NIM has been coupled with increase in fresh business for the company. That, of course, has led to 14% jump in profit before tax. What is the trend you think going forward? Do you think you'll be able to maintain the kind of profitability or margins here on, or do you see some concerns out there for the next coming quarters?
I think, given that our focus has been on four products, which is used SME, tractors, and mortgage, we see the those products have high ROAs and NIMs, and we continuously will move in that direction. So we used to be about 42% of the book 2 years back. We're at 59%, and we expect to take that to 70% in a couple of years. So we don't see NIMs shrinking as we go forward.
And what is the loan book looking like, sir, now?
The loan book is about 18,000 crores.
Right. So in terms of your the traction that Tier 2, Tier 3 is offering, what are the prospects going there, and what are the internal targets, if you can share that with us?
It will be difficult to share internal targets. Obviously, we are looking at growth in disbursements this year by about 20%, and those will then get reflected in the book as we go forward.
Right. Provisions this time have been 87 crores as opposed to 98 crores in the previous quarter. Do you see moderation in the same going ahead?
As I said, you know, with the monsoon playing out and the spends by the government, the MSP, and the pay commission, we should see the benefits in the second half of the year.
Sir, one quick point I wanted to check with you on the cabinet approving liberalization of FDI norms for NBFCs. You think your company is looking for any of this, and what's your own take on this subject?
I have enough investors in us as an organization. So we have five private equity players already there, KKR, India Value Fund, Leapfrog, IFC and Chris Capital.
So not really looking at it.
Not right.
All right, Mr. Bansal, many thanks for joining us and sharing your views on the numbers that we've seen. Pretty decent numbers and a good growth outlook from the company from here, Pranoy. The stock is also positive in trade, and I think all in all, they've seen this NIM providing that boost to the company. All right. Stock up 2% as we speak, but we slip into a short break here. On the other side, Ashish Kumar Chauhan of BSE is confident of listing the exchange by early next year. Exclusive conversation on the other side.
We realize very soon we had not touched this one.